Hey everybody, it's Tammy, and today I'm really excited to take you guys on a little bit of a journey as I try and do something that I've wanted to do for years, and that's 3D print my own barnacle parts out of resin. I'm going to show you guys the process I went through to successfully print my first masks, and also some of the problems I had along the way. I'm going to quickly go through some of the basics of resin printing in case you're not familiar with it. If you are familiar, you can use the timestamps below to skip to the next bit. So, resin printing is one of the two main types of 3D printing, along with fused deposition modelling or FDM printing. Both versions have some similarities in that you first have to take a 3D object and use software to slice it into hundreds of layers, and then the printer creates the object one layer at a time. With FDM printing, a little nozzle heats up a plastic-like filament and squirts it out whilst moving backwards and forwards and across to print out each layer at a time. Whereas with resin printing, you have a vat of resin with a screen underneath that flashes up a layer at a time. And because the resin is sensitive to UV light, it solidifies, and this is called curing. The main advantages to printing with resin rather than FDM is because it's generally faster, especially if you're doing multiple models in one print, and because the quality of the final result is generally much better. The main downside with resin prints is that you have to do some post-processing afterwards, and that can be a little bit tricky to get right, as you'll see. The resin itself is also toxic unless it's properly cured, so you need to be very careful when handling and disposing of it. Compare this to FDM printing, where once the print is done, you can just pop it off the plate and it's safe. I did a lot of research on resin printing before getting mine, and I would recommend doing the same thing, and even with my research I ended up making some mistakes, which you'll see later in the video. Luckily there's a really active online community with lots of reviews and information. I ended up getting the Elegoo Mars 2 non-pro version, and I think it was a return, so I got it slightly cheaper. If you're able to wait a little bit longer, I would recommend getting a printer with a DLP screen. They cost more up front, but are probably worth the investment because you save money and time by not having to replace the screen nearly as often or at all. Aside from that, from a quality point of view, pretty much all resin printers on the market right now are perfectly good for printing construction scale parts. Most resins up until now have needed to be washed off with isopropyl alcohol or IPA. However, since the pandemic, this has been in particularly short supply. And also, I have ADHD, so I really don't need to have any more chemicals hanging about than I need to. Thankfully, a relatively recent development is water washable resin. This doesn't mean that the resin is safe, far from it, it's just as toxic as regular resin, and any water that you bring into contact with it, you have to keep contained and eventually dispose of in an appropriate facility. It did, however, mean that I could just get tap water to rinse the prints. Resin can be kind of expensive, so I tried to get the best value by getting a big bottle of transparent red, since it just happened to be cheap at the time, and it looks cool, as you'll soon see. With everything unpacked, I moved my new toy into the conservatory, which was a good choice for a couple of reasons. Firstly, it's got a dirty great door in it that can open up for ventilation, and secondly, it was easy to close off to the rest of the house so the cats wouldn't come in and try and drink it. Once it was plugged in and turned on, I had to sort out a couple of things like updating the firmware and leveling the build plate, and then we were good to go. Except I was missing just one thing. Things to bloody print. To the computer! One of the best websites for freely sharing 3D models is Thingiverse. It's a really cool site. There's tons of models there, including barnacle stuff. It's really great. You can even tip the creators. Now, I might have been here before and bookmarked just one or two masks. So let's have a look. I think I'm going to start off with Helrix's. I'd like to compare that to my FDM printed version. This one, at time of recording, is the mask on the winning Garki design. I love it. I think it looks amazing. I'm going to get a sensory aptitude mask for my boy Cooler, see if I can pop those eyes into the back of the mask. I'm going to get the Canon mask creation for Artaka. Can't wait to see what a resin printer does with that.
No way, I'm not getting Kinkei's original version as well. That's not standing
mask. Turaga Lakan's noble mask of shielding. Yes,
adaptive
please.
Nuva masks. Gimme.
Kanoe Elise is a must
noble
have.
Noble mask of flight.
Mask of possibilities.
Style Picari.
A cuddly toy.
And this guy, who is he?
Rothanak.
Oh my sweet Jesus, those movie masks look good.
So after downloading one or two files, the time had come to set up my first plate. By which I mean I need to choose and prepare which models I want my printer to actually print on its first run. Now the most sensible option would be to use a test print or just print off a single model to begin with. So I put four on! Next I had to add supports to all the models. This is really important because it actually anchors the thing you're printing to the build plate, and so it doesn't just go floating away half finished. The last thing to do is just let the software slice the model into lots and lots of layers that the printer will cure to build up the model. So with everything set up and transferred to my USB stick, it was time to scurry on back to the printer and actually get printing. I popped the USB stick into the printer, I popped the vat on top of the LCD screen, and then I just had to pour the resin into the vat. All resin is toxic, remember, which is why I'm wearing gloves, a mask, and I've got the door open to outside.
And that was it. All I had to do was press the start button, wait, and hope that everything would go well. Unfortunately, it didn't take too long for things to not go well. The printer was making a clunking noise every time it finished a layer, so I paused the print and there was some excess resin attached that was curing where it shouldn't be, and it was interfering with the printing process. The first time it went wrong, I tried cutting off the excess bit to see if it could continue printing at least most of the other models, but it wasn't long before it started happening on the other masks as well, and I had to abandon the print. Normally, the resin in the vat should stay completely liquid, but unfortunately mine had formed a bit of a skin on the top, and so I was going to have to dump the entire lot and start again. This time I decided to just print one beautiful mask so that if it came out well, I could really see what this printer could do. So naturally I went with Kinkei's original mask of creation. I also found that my issue was quite a common one, which is that the default settings for my printer don't cure the first few layers of resin for long enough, so part of it can detach or come loose and interfere with the rest of the print. So I just increased the curing time to about a minute for the first five layers. And with that, it was time to head back to the printer.
Okay, so attempt two, we're gonna go for Kinkei's mask of creation. I've put a lot less resin in this time. Let's see how we go. Wish me luck. So, 2 hours later, it's just 100%ed. And it's attached. See that? Yeah, it's stuck. Eek. I'm excited. Shit. Now I have to actually cure this. Yes. What you are looking at there, my friends, is a transparent red mask of creation as designed by Kinkei. That's very cool. Right, I better get on with post-processing this. Okay, so because this is water washable resin, I've got a little container of water here. I've got the scraper. I'm going to try and take the build plate off and drop it into this water. Because it needs to be washed of excess resin. It seems to have stopped. Look at that, that is lovely. Right, I am going to pop this off carefully. There we go, that's some progress. Yeah! There it is. A little bit of shape. Now, I stupidly don't have any kind of UV curer yet, so I'm going to have to leave this mask to cure in the morning sunlight.
And I quickly got my printer up and running again on a second set of prints, but those were going to take another couple of hours, so in the meantime, I took my newly minted mask of creation outside and used clippers to start removing the supports connected to the back of the mask. The benefit of doing this outside was that any small bits of resin that got lost would get thoroughly cured in the UV light of the sun. Once I removed the structures from the most sensitive part of the mask, I tried removing the rest of them in one go, which resulted in this lovely noise.
Oh my god. Look at this. It is beautiful. Okay, now I am excited about 3D resin printing. Like, this is beautiful.
As you can probably tell, I was quite excited by the results, and so I was quite pleased to print out my second plate, which contained two masks, a Garki mask and a Kanoe Seletu for Krakua. My third print contained three masks that included a Noble Hau for Taraga Lakan, a Canon mask of creation, and an adaptive Kakama Nuva for a video which you may have already seen. Yes, it's taken me quite a while to make this video. Here are all six masks after I cured them in the sunlight. One technique that's supposed to help cure resin prints normally is to put them in water. Unfortunately, this is not a good idea for water washable resins because they can actually absorb water and expand. You might notice that the later prints have more white markings on them, and that is traces of resin from the previous prints in the water that I used to wash them. So it just meant that those masks didn't quite come out as well as I'd like them to, but I'll try them again in the future. I did also try to do a fourth print with four masks, which did finish printing, but they came out very wonky. I'm going to show them here quickly to you, but I'm going to reprint them and feature them in a future series of videos that I'm planning.
As for the good prints, the next step was to prime them, which, believe it or not, I've never actually bothered before when painting regular masks. But here it was really interesting to see how the opaque layer on top of the clear resin brought out all of the textures and details of each design. Honestly, I'd love to see every mask with this kind of frosted effect. This also allows you to more easily see the layer lines from the printing process. All of these masks were printed with a layer thickness of 0.05 millimeters. That means that every millimeter is made up of 20 separate printed layers. On future prints, I'm hoping to go as low as 0.02 millimeters, although this will more than double the printing time. And so onto the masks in all their painted glory. First up, we've got the mask from the winning Garki model. I think this mask to me looks the most like a real design by Lego. It just blends in flawlessly and looks really great on the model, although I understand that the designer, Galva, wants it to be switched out for the final artwork. Next up, we've got the Noble Howe, inspired by the second movie. This one ended up with some residue around the mouth area, which is really disappointing, but I will definitely try printing this one out again and maybe doing it in gold. The Stiletto I did in gunmetal, and I'm having to hold it because I accidentally snapped the axle off. Luckily, it does stick to the face pretty well with blue tack. I'll probably print another one of these as well. I also did King K's original Mask of Creation in gunmetal, and I think it looks bloody stunning. It really fits the colour scheme well. I'm probably going to do another one of these in gold at some point. I of course have the Canon version, which, since I already have a gold FDM version for the time being, I'm going to keep primed because I have some plans for this one. And then to contrast, here is a closer look at the adaptive Kakar Maneuver that I printed off and painted without any primer because I was rushing for the Pohatu video. And so we come to the end of the beginning of my barnacle printing journey. Apologies if I've skipped over certain details, there was a lot to go through. Keep an eye out over the next few months as I'm going to have more videos involving barnacle prints that I think you're going to enjoy. If you haven't seen my video already about the FDM printed masks that a friend kindly did for me, it'll be on the right hand side of the screen now. Either way, thanks for watching, take care, and I'll see you soon. Bye!